Guys, back in our video. Today we'll be showing you how to set up your haunting ghost bride from Home Depot this year. Parts list: base looks like this, smaller piece of fabric, hip joint, two smaller poles, torso with veil and head and arms attached, larger piece of fabric, and then the module. Okay, let's go ahead and start. What you want to do is take your base, and there should be two holes on your smaller piece of fabric. Make sure the pieces of Velcro are facing towards the top. It does not matter what angle this goes on or anything. That's why it Velcros on. And then there you go. So now this piece of fabric's on there covering the base, so you don't see it when you put it together. Now, you got your speaker, volume control, Tri-Me jack, DC adapter hole, foot pad, on, off, timer, foot pad. As you can hear, she has batteries in her for me. Alright, and what we're going to do is turn this around to where the A's on the pole face you. And then you're going to just this down, and there you go. Now what we're gonna do is take the wire label G and connect that to the wire coming from the control box label G and plug those in together. Boom. Now what we're gonna do is get the hip piece and these two poles, and we're gonna push this in right here, the piece, there you go, great, and then you're gonna take the pole labeled C and connect C to C. But first what you gotta do is at the top here, there's a little hole, and you're going to slide that down in there. And we're going to slide this down in there. There. And then right here, there's a little clip that slides back and hooks around the hole. Alright, here comes the springs. On the back, there should be a hook. That spring goes there. This spring, where's it going? Yeah, this spring goes all the way over here. And yellow to yellow, blue to blue. Pretty easy. Yeah. So, right now if you turn around, you see still works, but you can't use her like that because it won't be able to lift her up. This just helps her. You can tell her mechanism is very, very loud. Alright, now to take your smaller pole, And we're going to start coming up here. Now, what we got to do, connect D to D. Simple, simple. And then what we got to do is take your longer fabric and slide that on over here. A lot of people miss this because they throw it away because they think it's a bag. But there's Velcro on the bottom. This is what this holds down. So yeah, just kind of bunch it up like that. You'll see why in just a second. Actually, wait, no, you're supposed to do this. So never mind, forget what I just said there. And pull this all the way down. All the way down. Don't worry about the Velcro just yet at the bottom. We'll get to that in a second. So now it's starting to come together. Now it's time for the last piece, the torso with her creepy, creepy face. I took the roses off because I didn't like them. You don't have to if you don't want to. Yeah. So go ahead and stretch your arms out. And whatnot, just so out of your way. Now what you want to do, flip her upside down, go towards the end of her dress, and kind of go through the foam and stuff. And then there should be a long one. And then if you go even farther, there's a pole. And you want to grab that pole, make sure the wire that's in there is plugged in, and connect the poles together. There. Okay. Now what you're going to do is take the wire that's coming down here. Make sure to plug this in, otherwise her arms don't move and her eyes won't light up. A lot of people forget to plug this one in. So at the bottom, connect F to F, and then you can Velcro the Velcro now if you want to. You don't have to, but it helps cover up the module while it's moving, because sometimes that'll become exposed, and you can see the motor and everything. So yeah, go ahead and Velcro everything down here. And it's pretty easy. There we go. F. Now, pull the foam down and adjust the foam real quick. And then now, pull the dress down. The dress is very large. And you just kind of pull that out, make it look good. And now is the time to pose her arms and adjust her as you would want her to look. Right now she looks like a hot mess, so I gotta pull her hair down a bit because it's all bunched up on top of her head and sticking out. So, now is the time I recommend you to get like a bobby pin or something. Just so you can there. So yeah, just pull her hair a little bit. Won't hurt her, it's an inanimate object. And get the hair out of her face and go grab a bobby pin. Now you can just use this bobby pin and pin her hair back out of her face. And when the veil is on, you don't even see it. And especially if you have a black bobby pin, that'll help. Now adjust the veil. behind her and fluff her up as you want. Adjust her arms as you wish. Now what we need to do is go down here behind her dress, lift this up, and unvelcro one of these, and then you see her control panel. Now what you want to do is go ahead, turn it on, adjust the volume. Turn that down a bit. You see she starts going. She is sound activated, I think. Ow. And if you do not have that wire plugged in, her arms won't move up and down like this. And if you need to get to the back or anything to adjust her clothing, on the Velcro this once she stops moving eventually. And you can get to her motor. Dang, she had to stop at her highest point. You can see the motor in there is moving. So that means her arms will move. If you don't plug that in, her arms won't move. When she has less movement, she won't look as cool. But otherwise, yeah. Hope you guys like this video. Like and subscribe. Bye. Have a nice day.